kilogram is how to find how to calculate the magnitude and direction of the given force system and what is the location of the result. So both the questions are asking in the same problem. Now see the problem. This diagram is given like this. The distances is given like this. It is a point A, point B, C and D. So these are 2 meter and then 7 meter and 3 meter. So both the magnitude and the direction of the given system is given like this. You consider the all the four forces are acting on the same plane. So it is a coplanar. And then what is this parallel force? It is not a parallel to each other because the line of axis is not to be parallel. When you take this 40 units acting vertically downward, similarly the 75 units acting vertically upward. And then these two are the point of application is in the output, but in plane it is not a parallel to each other. So this force system is called as a non-parallel coplanar force system. Okay, now we start the solution. How to calculate the resultant force? We know this concept of the resultant force calculation is obvious. We have to take the resolution of this force. So, example, this is called as a resultant force, or it is a sum of horizontal force, or it is a F1. This value is a F1 cos theta, so theta is given like this, and then F1 sin theta. Because we know this theta angle is tan theta equal to F1 sin theta by F1 cos theta. So already we have studied in the last video for this answer. Now we have to apply this concept in this problem. Then we have to calculate the magnitude and direction of the resultant force. Okay, in this system there is no horizontal component. It is acting vertically downward only. It is acting vertically upward. There is no horizontal component. So you have to resolution of the forces are these two. How to make the resolution? Already we have studied in the first unit. How to calculate the resultant force in the concurrent forces. Similarly, the same principle and concept is applied for this resolution of these two inclined forces. First thing, we have to take from this 65 kilonewton. How to make the resolution? It is just like this. This is here 65 newton. So you have to take the resolution by this concept. So it is a horizontal component and a vertical component, correct? So here the angle is given 45 degrees. So take the resolution here 65 cos 45. Similarly 65 sin 45. This is exactly part of this procedure. And then the similarly part, the 27 newton like this. 27 meter. So take the resolution of this command like this. Correct? So it is here 27 sin, the angle is here 30 degree. 27 sin 30. Similarly 27 cos 30. Okay. Now this diagram is again modifying into free body diagram. All the forces are given in this force system. At the point A, it is acting vertically downward, there is no changes. Only one vertical force. Now take this resolution of the 65 newton. How to make the resolution? So you have to make it like this. So this is here force acting do like this. This is a 30 newton. Sorry, 27 newton. The angle is 30. So we have to make the insulation like this. It is there. And then it is between the and then up. So it is a 27 sine 30 and 27 cos 30. And then the last of course, this is a vertically upward 75. So make this point B, C, D. In between this distance is a 2 meter, then 7 meter and 3 meter. Okay. Now we will make a resolution of the resultant force. Sum of all the horizontal forces is first we will calculate how many number of the horizontal forces. Take this system, it is having only one vertical component and then another one is having two components, horizontal and and then 75 newton is not a horizontal cost. So you have to carefully take the values. This 65 cost part is towards the positive x direction. So it is a plus 65 cost part. Then this value is minus because it towards the negative x direction. 27 cost part. Any other forces? No. Similarly, we have to calculate 65, it is acting vertically upward 65 sine 45 and then plus again it is acting vertically upward then 27 sine 45. So now in this calculation we can easily calculate the resultant force, magnitude and the direction. But where it is located? Location that is another question. So at the time we have to calculate the another thing, the moment to remove. So apply the Newton's theorem. What is the sum of all the units equal to the total of the single force that is called as a resultant force into this. Already we know the concept of the moment is a force into perpendicular distance. So here we know this R value is calculated and x we don't know and then sum of the moment is we don't know. So you have to calculate the moment. Taking moment at A. Taking moment at A. So here the sum of the moment at the point A. Calculate calculate the value already we have discussed in the moment calculation. So at the point A, you take this A. A there is no moment because it is having only the magnitude of the force. There is no perpendicular distance here. It is a starting point. So what is equal? 0. There is no perpendicular distance. Either positive or negative. Okay, now come to the point at B. It is an inclination force. Already we have resolution of horizontal and vertical component. Now here the horizontal component. So horizontal and horizontal distances. So we have to cancel this one. There is no moment. The moment is 0. Then another force is acting vertically upward. So see that up to A to B, the distance, the perpendicular distance is 2 meter. So 65 sin 45. So point of application is acting like this. What is the direction? It is a anticlockwise. So the minus 65 sin 45 into the perpendicular distance is 2. Then come to the point C. See here again 27 cos 30 and 7 meter. These two are the parallel to each other, so there is no moment. And then next, the 27 sin 30 is that again you consider the point of application towards the point A. Again the same, which one? Anticlockwise direction. So take the distance. Anticlockwise direction is minus. Then 27 sin 30 into, you calculate calculate the distance from A to C, not A to C. A to C because the moment is dragging at the part A. So 2 plus 7 into 9. And then see the spherical force is given here. So this point of application is also in the anticlockwise direction. So it is also minus 75 into total distance, because the moment is taking from A. So 7 plus 3, 10 plus 12. So this is a total calculation of the moment at A. So now we know the have to apply now in this formula. Sum of the moment in terms are Newton meter. So you have to calculate this value. Just I have some assumption, I have given some values in the part. Similarly, this value is here, 42.7. So, it is just an approximate value, I am not taking the correct value in the part. Then, the resultant force is coming like this, 22.5 whole square plus 42.7 whole square half square. So this value, just you have to assume that the momentum, it is on 95. And then the angle is approximately 21 degree. Now the moment of value is approximately 220 Newton meter or 110 Newton meter. Now substituting this formula, 110 equal to R the value, R value is 95 into X. So you have to calculate what is the value of the X. So, this is 110 divided by 95. It is approximately 1.2 meter. So, finally, you have to substitute these values from the point A. A to 1.2 meter. 1.2 meter. It is a 1.2 meter, and then acting the forces inclined at 21 degree. Right? Point of application, the magnitude value is positive. Then, when the point of application is in the outside or inside, so we have to carefully calculate these two values are the positive. So, this will be acting vertically. And then what is this angle? Angle is 21 degree, and then the resultant force value is 90 degree. So you have to mark it at the dark line in the exam. It is called as a location of the this one. The distance is 1.2 meter. Clear? So it is a basic concept of parallel force system solution.